guys, hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Punya here and I am welcoming you all to my YouTube channel, that is Punya's Biology, PM Biology. And here we are here to go for the part 8 of the chapter, that is biotechnology and its application. So we are going for gene therapy. You can press on the I button which is shown on the right hand corner of the YouTube channel for my other videos. So let's start the topic, that is gene therapy. So next is our application. Next application is for gene therapy. So first clinical gene therapy was given to a 4-year girl who was suffering from ADA deficiency in the year 1990. ADA deficiency in the year 1990. So we can say that it's very recent one, right? 2020 and 1990. So first clinical gene therapy was given to a 4-year-old girl for ADA deficiency in the year 1990. So what does this ADA stands for? ADA stands for adenosine deaminase. Adenosine deaminase. Since it is ending with ASC, that means it's the enzyme. So this enzyme is responsible for formation of B as well as T lymphocytes. B and T lymphocytes. So ADA deficiency results in a condition called SCID. So deficiency of ADA results with a disease namely SCID. SCID's complete or full form would be severe combined severe combined immunodeficiency disease. CIEMCY. Okay, SCID. So lack of this enzyme will be giving rise to a disease called SCID, that is severe combined immunodeficiency, SCID. So this is mostly found in newborn babies. Mostly this is common for newborn babies. They lack T and B lymphocytes. Okay. Next. In some cases, the patient can be treated by bone marrow transplantation. In some cases, the person can be treated by bone marrow transplantation. And when this bone marrow transplantation cannot be done, in that, gene therapy replacement is used. Gene therapy replacement technique is used. So gene therapy treatment. So in this, what happens? The functional ADA or the functional ADA is injected to the patient. So what will happen once this enzyme is injected to the patient? It can produce D and T lymphocytes. In both these cases, the problem persists and continuous treatment is required. So this is a continuous process. This enzyme needs to be injected whenever the patient is requiring it. So it's a continuous process. To treat this by gene therapy, first, so we are using gene therapy. So in this, what will be happening? The first step in gene therapy would be that ADA, complementary DNA, is synthesized by the process transcription. Reverse transcription. So first step of gene therapy would be, we have to produce ADA complementary DNA by the process reverse transcription. And then this needs to be introduced into the culture of patient's lymphocytes. These genetically designed lymphocytes are introduced to the patient's body. The patient body is injected with genetically got lymphocytes. Next, the lymphocytes have a short lifespan, as we all know. So the patient requires periodic infusions. That means till this lymphocytes would be there in the body of the patient, the body will not be having any problem for formation of B and T lymphocytes. And if the ADA producing gene is introduced into the cells bit earlier, then there are no chances of ADA deficiency. That means if a newborn is known to have this deficiency, ADA deficiency, at that time it can be introduced into the child, and then in future it will not have any ADA deficiency. So that's all for today's videos, like today's class. It was for gene therapy. So let's go for in the next videos about molecular diagnosis, and that would be part 9 of it. So let's wait for that video. Till then, watch my videos, like it, share it and subscribe, and share it with maximum so that it would be helpful for all those who are attending 12th, because it's a hard time now. So let's help each other to score good. Thank you. Have a nice day.